current energy healing practitioner, and just wanted to talk to you a little bit today about picking up your pendulum and starting to work with your guides. We're picking up again. If you got, you know, a little distracted from it, let's say that. I know that we need a community of healers to truly do better. We can't do it on our own. I know the first time that I truly started opening my mind, the window, as I call it, to other information, all the way. I mean, I was using a pendulum and using deductive reasoning and strategic thought process, and that's where I got where I am today. But it was through a sickness, an illness, and I had help. And I'm not saying everybody was perfect. You know, they weren't maybe as in-depth as they could be, but we didn't do trial and error. We used deductive reasoning and strategic thought process to get the herbals that I needed to heal when the medical industry couldn't take care of me. So I'm just here to ask you to please evolve. You're completely able to evolve. If you pick up a pendulum, it'll work for you. If it doesn't, well, maybe you're not going to evolve. Just kidding. Maybe you just need some chakra openings. That's probably the case anyway. I might have teased you a little bit. Sorry about that. But it's completely worth the process. And through diversity is usually when we learn how to work with them. Through some sort of illness, or mental illness, physical or mental illness, is when we can really tap into it and learn trust. That's when you start learning to trust your teachers, which are way, way better than going to college. I mean, I'm not saying don't go to college, but they're way more intelligent than that. All of the information that you ever wanted to know is already databased. It's already here. We just have to learn how to speak that language and get into that space. That's it. Might take a little work, of course, but that is it. That is the answer. All the information that ever is or has ever been is here, right now, available. The grass that grows, the birds that fly, it's already known. So you don't have to go around rediscovering everything all the time. You can use this information, along with human information, to get to where you need to be, whatever your passion is. If it's the arts, if it's rocket science, whatever it is. But first and foremost, which is what I teach, is self-care. You need to learn how to take care of yourself. First and foremost, that is always the case. And if you take care of yourself, you'll be able to let the rest of our generation and generations be healthy and happy. Let's see. I don't know. Actually, I'm going to check on this real quick. Wait, and I'll pick it up. There we go. So everything we do should be embedded with the ultimate of everything, the connection to the universe, which is the information of everything. No matter what you're doing in life, if it's connected to that, you take care of yourself, take care of your family, friends, to some degree, of course, you always first. You first, otherwise you can't do anything. And when we're embedded in that knowledge and that connection, that's when we truly evolve, that's when we grow, that's when we can actually make this world, well, maybe stop hurting this world, let's just say that, and make it a little bit better for us, for the all of us. Yeah, I guess that's all I have to say for today anyway. Yeah. Thank you.
Ah, the elusive pendulum. What do we do with it? Strategic thought process and deductive reasoning. Yes, indeed. Get your yeses and your noes and your maybes down. Okay, so you know what's yours, not somebody else's. And then what are we going to do with that? Well, let's use one example. Let's say somebody thinks you should take something for your health. Well, don't take their advice for it. Check with your guides to see if it's necessary. If they say it's necessary, okay, we can go from there. But if they say no, then you go, okay, well, would it be helpful to take it? And if it's helpful, you might want to choose to do that. And you can check with them to see how helpful it would be. Number two, what else would we ask? Okay, so with this herbal, how many times a day would I take it? Right? But you have to get this down to one question. That's it. So should I take it one time a day? If they say no, well, then you say, should I take it two times a day? And if they say no, say three times a day, and you finally get a yes, you're like, okay, you're on track, right? Yeah. And then dosage. Yes. So then if let's just pretend that it's a tablet, all right, just a little tablet. So you're taking it three times a day, and the first time you take it, should you take one tablet? Let's say they say yes. You say, every single time I'm supposed to take this, am I supposed to take one? Maybe they say no. So then you go through in the morning, the first one, do I take it once? And if they say yes, great. And then the second time, do you take it once? Just one tablet? And they say yes, great. And so you check for your third dosage in the evening before you go to bed, and you ask, okay, so it's not one, we already know that. So is it two tablets? And they say yes. So you have the process right there. You know you should be taking it, and you know you take one tablet in the morning, one tablet in the afternoon, and two tablets in the evening. There we go. Now, you can ask, is that all I need to know? And they might say yes, or they might say, nope, you need to know more. But I will give you a heads up. When you're taking a medicinal, maybe you're not going to take it forever. So the other question might be, let's see, I wonder how long I should be taking this. But you can't just ask that because your window's not open yet. So you're going to use strategic thought process and deductive reasoning yet again to figure out how long you might should be taking this. So you can use the same process. 1 week. Oh, they say yes. And then you're like, but see, there's the other thing there you might want to ask. It's like, should I just check in 1 week to see if I should change what I'm taking or how much I'm taking? Oh, that's a big yes. There we go. So checking in on your dosage every once in a while is very good. Write this stuff down so you don't forget. Okay? And then you can ask, is that all I need to know for right now? Yes, that's lovely. So there's a little tiny example of deductive reasoning and strategic thought process. All right, I love you guys. Try to do something, keep it up, don't give up. And if you need some help, I do private lessons. All right, love you, namaste.